Hello everybody, this is Digital Blackboard by Sachin P. Nagmote, Assistant Professor at St. Vincent Pallotti College of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur. So in this video, we are going to discuss the topic why single phase induction motor is not self-starting. Okay, so let's start. So we know that single phase induction motor works on single phase supply. Now, what will happen if single phase supply is given to the single phase induction motor? So in induction motor is basically an AC motor. It works on AC, and induction motor is having two main parts, that is stator and rotor. The stator is called as stationary part or input part, and the rotor is called as output part or rotating part. And in between stator and rotor, there is an air gap. So it is just like a transformer. So as in transformer, there is primary and secondary. In case of induction motor, we are having stator and rotor. Now, when single phase supply is given, that is AC single phase supply is given, then what will happen? The single phase current will flow, and the single phase current is nothing but alternating current will flow, and this alternating current is changing with respect to time. So when single phase supply is given to single phase winding, to single phase induction motor, then definitely when current is flowing through the winding, the flux will set up, but that flux is in alternating nature. So alternating nature flux, it means it is changing its direction and magnitude with respect to time. So alternating flux has been set up in the stator. Okay, so this is clear. So after giving single phase supply, single phase current will flow, and this single phase current will set up alternating flux in the stator. Okay, now as alternating flux has set up in the stator, the flux will passes through the air gap, and after passing through the air gap, it will goes over the rotor. Now the flux, you can see the flux is cutting the rotor conductors, but as the flux is cutting the rotor conductor, then we know whenever there is flux linkage, and if the flux linkage is changing with respect to time, so according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, EMF will get induced in that conductor. So that is the Faraday's law. So here same thing is happening. The alternative flux set up in the stator, it passes through the air gap, and it is cutting the rotor conductor. So according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, there is rate of change of flux with respect to time, and hence EMF will induce in the rotor. So we got EMF in the rotor, that let it be E2. Now as rotor conductors are closed circuit, so current will also flow in the rotor conductor. So let that current is I2. Okay, so once again we will revise it. So single phase supply is given to the stator winding of single phase induction motor, it set up alternating flux in the stator, and this flux passes through the air gap, and it is cutting the rotor conductor. And as it is cutting the rotor conductor, there is rate of change of flux with respect to time, so EMF induced in the rotor conductor, and as rotor conductor is a closed circuit, current will flow in the rotor. Now the direction of this current is given by Lenz's law. Okay, and according to Lenz's law, the direction of current will such that it will oppose the cause producing it. Now what is the cause of this rotor current, that is I2? So here the cause of rotor current is alternating flux, because current is generated, current is flowing because of E2 is there, induced EMF is there, and induced EMF is there because of there is rate of change of flux with respect to time. And why the flux is changing with respect to time? Because alternating flux is there. Okay, so the cause of this current, the current will flow in such a direction so that it will oppose the alternating flux. So due to this, what will happen? As to oppose the alternating flux, the rotor conductor will set the torque will develop on the rotor conductor, but the torque will be also alternating. So alternating torque will develop on the rotor conductor. Now what is alternating torque? So it is equal and opposite torque. Okay, so as torque is there experienced on the rotor conductor, but the torque is equal and opposite. So the total torque or the net torque is zero, because no unidirectional torque. If unidirectional torque is there, then rotor would have rotated. But as there is alternating torque or equal and opposite torque, so there is no unidirectional torque and net torque is zero, and hence the motor will not rotate. It means the rotor of single phase inductor motor is not able to rotate. So this is the reason. Because after giving single phase supply to the single phase induction motor, the torque which is developed on the rotor conductor is not unidirectional torque. The torque which is developed on the rotor of induction motor is equal and opposite torque, and hence the net torque is zero, and hence motor will not rotate. And that is the reason, single phase induction motor is not self-starting. Okay, so this is the reason behind single phase induction motor is not self-starting. So I hope that you understood the concept why single phase induction motor is not self-starting. So in only one sentence, we can conclude it that when single phase supply is given, there is alternating flux, and because of alternating flux, there is alternating torque. So these three concepts has to be kept in mind: single phase supply, alternating flux, and alternating torque. As alternating torque, it means net torque is zero, and hence the rotor is not able to rotate. Okay. Similarly, we can understand it by use this slide. See, single phase supply, alternating flux, and alternating torque. So there is equal and opposite torque, so net torque is zero, and that's why there is no continuous rotation for the rotor of single phase induction motor. So as you can see here, okay, now the thing is that one question may come in our mind that why three phase induction motor is self starting. So three phase induction motor is self starting because of the three phase supply, because when three phase supply is given, we got rotating flux. That is the main difference. When single phase supply is given, we got alternating flux, but when three phase supply is given, we got the rotating flux, and rotating flux is able to produce rotating torque. And that's why, as rotating torque means what? Unidirectional torque is available in the three phase induction motor, and that's why three phase induction motor runs continuously. Okay, the rotor of three phase induction motor runs continuously. So this is the reason. So here we can see alternating torque. So rotor is rotating alternately, so there is equal and opposite torque, and hence net torque is zero. And in this case, there is unidirectional torque, and hence the rotor is running continuously. Okay. Now the next thing is that how to make single phase induction motor self-starting. So for that, there is one concept, and that concept is called as, and the principle is called as, split phase principle. Now what is this split phase principle? So here we can see, this is the rotor of induction motor and stator. So in the stator, we are having one winding only. Okay, single phase induction motor will be having only single phase supply for is only having one winding in that. So instead of using one winding to make it self-starting, we have to use one more winding, and that winding is called as auxiliary winding or starting winding. Okay. Now instead of one, two windings are provided. Now these two windings are designed such that the currents are 90 degree phase shifted from each other. So main winding and auxiliary winding or starting winding are designed such that these winding currents are 90 degree phase shifted from each other. So the two current produces two fluxes, and which are also phase shifted from each other, which produces rotating magnetic flux. Okay, so to have the rotating magnetic flux, we require two phase or three phase. Single phase is not able to produce rotating magnetic field, but two phase, three phase fluxes can together resultant can be having the rotating magnetic flux, and this rotating magnetic flux then produces the unidirectional torque, and the single phase induction motor become self-starting. Okay, so now here we can see which kind of flux is setting up. The rotating flux has been set up, and that's why there is unidirectional torque on the rotor, and our rotor will rotate continuously. So this is the principle used behind making single phase induction motor self-starting. And there are different types of single phase induction motors available. The split phase induction motor, which works on split phase principle, then is capacitor start induction motor, then capacitor start, capacitor run induction motor. So in this video, we have seen why single phase induction motor is not self starting, then why three phase induction motor is self starting, and what is the principle used to make single phase induction motor self starting. So I hope you got better understanding about all these topics. So please like, share, and subscribe. And for any query, you can contact Sachin Nagmote at gmail.com. Thank you very much.